Supreme Court earlier today ruled that Aruna Shanbhag must be allowed to live. But more crucially, the verdict for the first time allows the legal option of passive euthanasia.
Justices Karju and Gyan Sudha Mishra today dismissed social activist Pinky Virani's plea seeking euthanasia for Aruna Ramchandra Shanbhag, a nurse who's been in a semi-comatose state for the last 37 years. Now the bench also made a landmark judgment by saying that while active euthanasia was illegal under Indian laws, yet passive euthanasia could be made permissible in exceptional circumstances.
The judgment which has been passed is quite a lengthy judgment. It is more than 110 pages and we haven't gone through the whole judgment. So I cannot comment very much on the what has been written in the judgment. But the only thing which I can say which transpired in the court is that the court has permitted passive euthanasia and has laid down certain parameters and conditions for taking benefit of passive euthanasia.
37 years have passed and she has suffered for no fault of her own, and now at least she should not be given, I'm not in favor. Let the God decide as per the nature, because birth and death are in the hand of God, according to me. And it's my personal opinion. Another thing, I have a fear that once this is done, this should not be used for selective reasons, you know. That's my great fear. In our country, there are number and number of cases like this. This is one case, we are aware about it. But there are many more.
After the Supreme Court's verdict, the Supreme Court has rejected the plea of Pinky Virani.
Madam, we are really happy by hearing this decision because we feel that it's a real victory of our nursing profession, because all these years, right from 1973 till date, our nurses are taking care of Aruna Shanbhag. Especially our student nurses are taking more care of Aruna Shanbhag. Initial days, she was very bad. She was in a critical condition. But maybe after giving the care by our students and giving the medical care by the KEM doctors, we feel that she is stable now.
Like our small girl, or now according to her age, she become old. Otherwise, she's the same. She's taking whatever food. Our parents or old age people are asking the food. Yes, same way she's taking the food like a small child. We are treating her like a small child. But whenever she wants the food, she scream and she take the food. If she's left, then after she scream, she tells from her expression. She tells everything. She says, now I'm wet, please change me. So we are taking her care. Whatever demand her has, we are giving, fulfilling her demand.
Whenever you take a committee, see that the nurses also should be in their committee. The nurses are the person who will be there for 24 hours. No other person like a nurse be in the ward for 24 hours. Because the committee nurses also should be there, because we were a person who would be able to tell. A condition is not going to be by what she eats. She eats the food, that is, we are satisfying with those things and all like that. Because we know she's not going to become okay, she's not going to stand up and just walk around. That all is okay. But the food what she takes, it feels like we just should not stop her hunger. Because in the hunger, we also understand and we wonder around the things and all like that, what the hunger is.
I'm very happy that Supreme Court has rejected the proposal for euthanasia. Because I strongly believe that India is not yet mature enough to handle these type of cases. Primarily because we are only talking about the convenience to look after somebody. We are talking about the financial difficulty posed by the faced by the family to look after somebody who is brain dead. This cannot be the reason for terminating.
No, I think what Supreme Court has given the judgment is correct. We are not yet prepared for any consent for passive euthanasia. And we are likely to make many, many misuse of these kind of permissions. And I personally feel passive euthanasia is not suited to our country as on today till we are mature enough to give decisions with a panel of right people.
Even the law minister has reacted to the Supreme Court judgment.
That is the law of the land. In fact, you know, this is a, even though, you know, there are a lot of humanitarian points to be looked at, even on the other side, there are humanitarian points, you know, this should not be used as an instrument by anyone, you know, to kill somebody. So at the same time, you know, there are people like Aruna Shanmugam who are suffering. So we'll have to examine the judgment delivered. Even in United States, only except two states, rest of the states, you know, there is no law to grant any such permission. So this is a very serious matter. We need to understand it in a world context and also in the context of the human, you know, the attitude and that we need to examine with all angles.
Because, you know, the suffering of Aruna has really not been understood well. Partly the reason is that, you know, the medical fraternity has not really, you know, come forward to help make this decision. I think it's extremely important that, you know, we should understand this is really, really sad to make a person suffer for 37 years and make her an example for medical system to prove to the nation that they are taking care of her so well, so that she can be, you know, put in this vegetative state for so long.
One more time when we have failed Aruna, because there could not have been a greater case for mercy. In this case, mercy being death. You know, it's really unfortunate that when we make a case for the defense of Aruna, we're really talking of the prosecution of Aruna. I think that this was a case where closure was absolutely imperative. The woman has been trapped in this, I won't even say living hell, because it's not even a living hell, for the last 37 years. She has been in this persistent vegetative state. We may all talk of the valiant effort that the nurses have made in taking care of her, but barring that, I don't think in the years when it mattered, enough was done to gauge the extent of her damage.